हेलो एवरीवन. सो टुडे वी विल बी कवरिंग टू पॉइंटर्स मेथड. सो लेट मी शेयर माय स्क्रीन. So let us start with this question. You have been given two sorted arrays and you need to merge them into a final sorted array. Like you can see the example, like we have two arrays, let us say A and B. Both of them are sorted. Like you can see if A is 1, 6, 9, 13, 18, 18 and B is something like this. So you need to merge them, and after merging, what will be the final sorted array after combining these two? So you need to print that. So try to write a code for it, but don't use sort function because it will be having a time complexity of n log n. So we do not want that log factor. Means we want to since the given arrays are sorted already, they are sorted, so we want to use this fact. So without actually calling the sort function, can we directly sort it in some way? Means I mean to say that in a time complexity of O of n plus m, like let us say it has a size n and array B has a size m, so we want that our merging should be done in big O of m plus n. So try to think of any approach, try to write the code for it. I will share a link for whiteboard where you can write it so that I can view it. So I will just share this link. You can try to write your answer here. Okay, just I have not told anything. Just repeat the. Okay, I will repeat the question. Like the question is that you are given two sorted arrays. Just I have shared the whiteboard link. Try to write the pseudo code or code over there. So I will review all the codes of yours. So just you can use this whiteboard link and just try to write the code over there. So the question is that you are given two sorted arrays. Means they are already sorted in non-decreasing order, or you can say like AI is less than equal to AI plus one, because all the arrays are sorted. Given they are already sorted, A and B, two arrays are given, and you need to output the final sorted array after merging these two arrays. Like if A and B are merged together, so whatever will be the elements, that all the elements after sorting, whatever order we will get, that order you need to print, that elements you need to print. So basically you need to merge them, and in the sorted way you need to print that final array. So I shared the whiteboard link. So in that whiteboard link, try to write your pseudo code or your C++ code over there. So okay, so I will not view it directly, and after writing your code I will just show you. Like After writing your code, there should be a save button. So after writing your code, you should save it so that I can view it. Without your saving, I would not be able to view your code. So currently, I'm not able to see anyone's code or something. So after whatever you have written, you need to press the save button so that I can view your code. So just try to solve it. The condition is that you cannot use sort function. Directly, you do not write sort. Just push all the elements of both array in one array and then you sort it. So that, no, don't write that code. Just try to utilize the fact that these two arrays are already given as sorted. So basically, you need to merge them in such a way that the final array which you get is already sorted. So this thing you need to do. Try to think of it. How will you do? I will wait for 5 minutes. And like input, don't take the input and output. Just you assume that already you are given two sorted arrays as input. Don't take the input and output in your code. Just I want that how your logic would work. So don't take the input and output. Just write how will you merge these two sorted arrays to get the final merge array, which is also sorted. And after writing your code in the whiteboard link I have shared in the chat, just save it so that I can view. Currently, I'm not able to view anyone's code. You need to save it so that I can view it. This is the whiteboard link I have shared in this chat. So here you need to try to write your code. So I will review the code of each and everyone so that you also come to know if you are doing any mistake. Okay, I can see one person's code. Okay, take 1 more minute, 1 or 2 minutes. And just after writing the code, there should be a save or push or something like that button, an option should be there. So just use that. Has anyone written the code? I cannot see it here. Like, you have not pressed the save button, I think. Okay, let us discuss it now. Enough time. Okay, one person has written more. Okay, someone has done swapping, but swapping would not be useful here, like. Swapping consecutive elements would not be useful, I think, here. Okay, let us discuss it now. So Vinod has told that we can take two variables. We can take one variable L for the first array, and for the second array we can take another variable R. And what we can do is, like, first we need he has not mentioned properly, but actually what we can do is okay, let me explain it over the whiteboard here. So what we can do is, in two pointers, generally what we do is take two pointers. Means what? Like here, pointers means you can say the index in an array. So like here we have two arrays, so I can take a variable for the index in this array and another integer variable for the index in this array B. So let us say I have drawn this example for, like, this is your array A here. So this is your array A here, and this one is your array B. So as you can see, the array A has size 6 and B has size 5. There are 5 elements in B. So we need to produce an output array, which would be the merged array of A and B. Like, merge means you need to combine these two. All the elements from A and B should be present in your final array. But it should be sorted one. It should be sorted in, you can say, non-decreasing order. So this is our, let us say, final array C. So my approach, I would say ki I have two pointers. Pointers mean index. Of in both the arrays. So let us say one index is I, which is pointing initially to the first element of A, and another I have J here. Okay, let me write this way. We have I here, and this I is pointing, let us say, here, and we have a variable J here, and J is pointing here. Okay, so what we can do is, at every step, just check whether which element, can you tell in chat, like, which element should be the first element in our final array? Already A and B are sorted. Okay, you know that A and B are given as sorted arrays. So which element should be the first element in your final array? Can anyone say, in general, like, how would you check it? Which element should be the first in your final sorted array? Actually, first element means who is the smallest out of all these elements. So how will you check it? How will you know which is the smallest out of these? Here it is one. So how will you check it? Okay, someone else has also saved the code on whiteboard, so I will just have a look at it. I cannot, I can see only two or three codes, so maybe okay. Okay, let it be, let us discuss it now. So, just I wanted to say ki, okay,
so min of A0 and it should be min of A0 and B0. Min of first element in both the arrays, the smaller one of first element in both the arrays should be the first element of your final array, because already A and B are given as sorted. So yes, the minimum of A0 and B0 should be the first element in the final merged array sorted, because you know that A and B are sorted already. So yeah, first compare the both, which is the smaller one. So basically what we will compare, whether A of I is less than B of J or not. There are only two cases. Either A of I will be, okay, so I can write it this way. A of I is less than B of J, less than equal to, let us say, if they are equal, then anyone we can take. So if A of I is less than equal to B of J, then which element should be coming in the C array, in the final array? So it should be this one. In the A of I should come here. So A of I should come here. Okay. So what we do is ki, just like here we compare which is smaller one, 1 and 2, which is the minimum, which is the smaller one. So I will just place it in my new array. And what I will do I plus plus. So this I will now be pointing towards. So okay. So this I will move towards the next position. So now this I is at 1. The pointer I is at 1. Pointer means here in this 2 pointer, I told you that pointer means a simple variable which is just pointing to an index of an which is just an index of an array. So like now I will come to this side because this element is already placed in our final array. Now again we compare the same thing, AI less than BJ or not. Like this AI element and this is the BJ element. So which one is the smaller one? So whichever is the smaller one, I will place it here. So like here, BJ is smaller. So I will place this BJ here, 2. I will place this 2 here because it is the smaller one. And what I will do, this J++, this J will shift towards the next element like this. So it will shift towards here, it to the next position. Again, what we do, again, compare the same thing. Is AI less than equal to BJ or not? Only there are two cases. Either it will be less than equal to BJ or not. So yeah, it is not the case. Like AI is greater than actually BJ. So what we will do, we will just, which means this BJ is smaller. So this smaller element will come here. So it will come to the next element of the final array. So, okay, sorry, I forgot to write 2 here. So actually 2 earlier J was here. So 2 should be here. Now this 3. Since it is out of 6 and 3, whichever is the smaller, 3 is the smaller, so 3 will come in the final array next. So you can see that in the final array, already we are getting the elements as sorted, like 1, then 2, then 3 in this way. So directly we are just comparing AI with BJ and we are just inserting the smaller element to the final array. Like here 3 was smaller, so we inserted that. And we are incrementing that pointer J to the next element again. So like J will now point to the next position. So 3 is here and J will again point to the next position. Is it clear or not? Like if it is clear, we will write the code for this. Again, we will compare AI and BJ. Whichever is the smaller one, I will place it in the new array. Like AI is 6, BJ is 8. So now this AI is smaller. AI is less than equal to BJ. This is true. So what we will do, this AI is smaller. So I will place this 6 in the new array C here. So like this 6 will come here and what I will do, I will increment this I. So this I will be incremented and so on. So this I will be incremented, it will point to the next element now in this way. So just this is a simple example of two pointers.
So I hope it is clear to everyone. Okay.
Yes, you can use set, but set will again have a time complexity of log n. And if you insert all the elements in a set, then n log n time complexity will be there. So we do not want that. We want to optimize it. We want to do it much faster as we can. So we use this two pointers method. So can, okay, first let us write the code for it now. So I will share the link of this question. So this question is available here on CodeForces. So if this link does not work, then I will show you how to open this question. So what you do, you go to CodeForces website, codeforces.com, and in codeforces.com, just I will just share this link also. So if you are not able to open the link, just go to codeforces.com in the edu section. Just in the edu section, you click on this register button should be there for you to register first and then enter this. So inside this, you will find two pointers over here somewhere at the last two pointers. So two pointers, step one practice. Go to this place, two pointers, step one practice. So you will find these three questions. So just I am talking about this first question now. So just go over here. So you will be able to find this question. So this question we will solve. Okay. So as you can see, this is the same question. Two sorted arrays are given and we need to merge it. So let us try to solve it now. Let us write the code. So I will share my screen again. So yeah, it should be visible. So the input format is like that. First line contains two integers n and m. N is the size of first array, m is the size of the second array. And then the first array elements are present and then the second array elements are present like this. So let us take the input. So it should be, let me remove this stuff, it is not required now. So yeah, we need two variables, n and m. Just take these two input. Then we need to take two arrays. Let us say I'm taking two vectors, one of size A. Let us say first array is A of size N, second array is B of size M. And then we need to first take the input of these N elements of the first array. So for int I equal to 0, I less than N, I plus plus. And what you should do, you just see in the value, see in AI. Fine. Then just go for the m elements of the next second array, array B, C in B of I. So you have taken the input. Now, what our approach was, we had taken two pointers in our approach. Two pointers, one is I for the first pointer in the first array, and J is a pointer in the second array. And starting value of both is 0. Initially, both are at 0, 0 index. So what we will do, we take two variables, int I equal to 0, j equal to 0. And let us take another vector, vector int c, which is the final array, final sorted array. Okay. So what we will do, we will you will tell me the condition of while, what should I write it here. So what we will do, we will just check if a of I is less than equal to b of j, then definitely which element we need to push back in our final array, we need to push back the smaller one, which is the smaller ai. And we do I plus plus, right? And otherwise, in the second case, if AI is greater than BJ, then what does it mean? It means that smaller element is BJ. So we push back the smaller one, BJ, in the final array, push back BJ, and do J plus plus, right? So up till when you will do this? What should be the condition here? Can anyone say? Try to answer in the live chat. What should be your condition in the while loop? So first find the second max of whole array. Okay. So this is wrong link. Okay. Okay, so I not equal to N or J not equal to M. Yeah, that should also work. No, that would not work. We should use AND here, not OR. Like, see, if any one of the arrays finished, like suppose I reach the end of the array, then you need to break. So if anyone reaches the end of the array, I or j, anyone reaches the end, then you need to break. So what you should write? You should write I less than n and then j less than m. This should work.
You can also write I not equal to n and j not equal to m. That will also work.
But and should be there.
If you write or, then it would not work properly. Because or means ki if anyone is true, then it will run the loop. So it, we do not want that. We want that if any one of the arrays finished, it should break out of the loop, right?
So, okay, it's fine. We have written this. So after, when it will come out of the loop, it will come when either I becomes equal to n or j becomes equal to n. If anyone is true, if anyone reaches the end, it will break out of the loop now.
So let us say I becomes equal to n. What does it mean? It means that all the elements of the array I are placed in this array. Like let us say 6, then let me fill 9, then 13, then 18, then again 18. And now let us say ki, let us suppose, I know that it is wrong because one more 13 should be there. But for a while, let us suppose that this array I is finished. Now I has become equal to n. N is 6 here. 6 elements are there, so n is 6. So I become equal to n. So now the work of I is over. Now what should we do? Let us say j is pointing, let us say here, somewhere here, or let it be here only. So what we want is ki now whatever element should be, whatever are remaining in B, we need to fill all the elements after that. So like here, if you see, okay, let me just again do it. So it should be like, if you compare it, which is the smaller here, 8 is smaller. So it will place 8 here, then j will move here. J is now 8 here. So which is smaller? So let us say AI is smaller. So it will insert 13. Then again, this 13 will get inserted. Then this 18 of AI. Then again, AI will get inserted 18. Now it should be correct to 1, 2, 3, 6, 8. Okay, let me do one thing. It should be 9 here. So this 9, it should be something like this. 9, 13, 13, then 18, then 18, like this. So I mean to say that now the array AI is finished. Now J will be pointing at this position. So whatever position J is pointing at, it is definitely true that this BJ will be definitely greater than whatever elements we have inserted up till now. So directly what we can do is whatever elements are remaining in the second array, we can directly push it back, directly push it in the final array. So directly without checking anything, we can directly insert it to our new array. I mean to say this. So what we can do is for the remaining arrays, we can directly push the elements. So it may be any of the case, like it may be possible that the second array is remaining now. First array is completely finished. Now the second array is remaining. So what we do, directly insert all the elements of second array to our final array, because the elements of the second and first array are already sorted, given to you. So while j less than m, m is the size of second array. So j less than m, what you do, c dot push back b of j and do j plus plus. Fine. And for the first array, while similarly, it may be the case that second array is finished, but first array is remaining. So anyone can be true, no? Like it may be possible that j become equal to n, like means the second array is finished, but the first array is remaining, is still less than n. So you need to insert all the elements of first array now directly without checking anything. So c dot pushback a of I and I plus plus, like this. So what I did, I just pushed back directly all the elements of a, whichever are remaining, to our final array. Okay, so let us see now. Okay, we need to print this final array. We need to print this C array. So for what should be the size of the final array? It should be definitely m plus n, because we have combined the elements of both A and B. So both the arrays A and B, all the elements are combined. So the size of final array should be definitely m plus n. I equal to 0, I less than m plus n, I plus plus. And then we just print all the elements, C out, C of I. And there should be a space between them. Okay, I missed a semicolon somewhere. C dot pushback AI. So okay, it should be semicolon here. So it should, okay, it is giving the correct output here. Let us submit it now.
So yeah, it is accepted.
So I will just paste the code over here also. So if anyone has any doubt, you can discuss it in the chat.
And if you don't have any doubt, like, we can come to the next question. So Vikram, you can discuss the next question. Okay.
Can you check my code? Okay, I will check your code first.
So
okay, let me check it. Okay, first let Hello? Me stop sharing.
Yes.
Take care. Screen dikh rahi hai na? हेलो
एक मिनट हाँ स्क्रीन दिख रही है
सो दिस इज द क्वेश्चन ओके सब लोग एक बार क्वेश्चन पढ़ लो So the question. Chirag, isme doc ka link daliyo ek bari.
Ha, ek minute.
Okay, so question is, you're given an array, okay, and you're given a number x. So you need to find three values at distinct positions such that their sum is equal to x. So basically you have to find three numbers from that array a, let's call them a, b and c, so and their sum should be x. So you need to return the positions of the values. So if you consider this test case, so this is the array 2, 7, 5 and 1 and x is your 8. So the output is 1, 3 and 4. So 1 is your 2, so 3 is your 5, 4 is your 1, so 2 plus 5 plus 1, so that is 8. So that's equal to x. So you have to find three numbers in the array, the position of the three numbers. Okay, so these are the constraints given. So try to do it like the basics. Can anyone give me a basic solution for this code, for this question? Brute force is three loops. Yes, that's correct. So basic solution can be that you run three nested loops, one for the first number, for second number and third for the third number, and you check if their sum is equal to x or not. So yes, that is correct. That's the basic solution. But now look at the constraints. So the constraints are n can be till 5000. So 5000, if you do it 5000 cube, that would work. Okay. N square log n, like not a triangle. Yes, you can. So one important point is that whichever question you can solve using binary search can also be done using two pointers, most of the questions. So they are like, they go hand in hand. So some people use binary search, some people use two pointers. So it doesn't make a difference in 90% cases, but it makes a difference in your interviews. Let's say if you give a solution using binary search, so there will be an additional login factor. So the interviewer might ask you to, you know, optimize it to bring it to N. So in that case, you will have to use two pointers. So that is why knowing two pointers is also very important. So yeah, N-scale login will work, but try to do it in N-scale. And N-cube will definitely not work, because you can see 5,000 cube would be more than 10^8. So if anyone thinks of any approach in N-scale, just write in the chat box. Recompute two sums first. Using two for loops. Okay. Yes, that can be done. Yes, you can store the sum of two numbers, two distinct numbers in a map, suppose. And then you can iterate again through the array and check. Yeah, you can do that. That's correct solution. But the thing is, can you tell me the Vinod? Can you specify the time and memory you're using, time complexity as well as the space complexity, both? And scare time, yes. And space, what about space? Okay, and now you are using two nested loops, right? So you are considering the sum of n minus 1 by 2 pairs, the sum of n square pairs approximately. So the time the space complexity would be n square. So that won't be order of n, that would be order of n square. So now the solution is correct. It would work in this question if you try to submit it here. But the interviewer might ask you that give me a order of n square solution with space complexity of order of 1. So in that case, think about
actually,
it.
Actually, I would share my experience. Like in my interview, this thing happened. Like a similar question was asked to me, and means throughout the whole interview of 1 hour, like this similar question was continued. Like I told a first O of n approach, then the interviewer told to reduce the, like I told first a solution using some space or a set or something, then he told to optimize it without using any space or something. So like in constant space and in O of n time complexity, like this. So this is very, very helpful technique for your interviews. Two pointers,
take two pointers in a loop, store their sum, and in the same loop nest another loop for finding the third number. I think in that case also, I think that's something similar to what Vinod said. So still that space complexity would be order of n square, I guess, or order of n, it would be at least order of n if you are trying to use it in the same loop. So think about it. think about it. How can you reduce the space? How can you do this question without storing anything? You cannot store anything, suppose. Okay, so yes, should start. So let's say your array is, suppose, let's take the same which is given in the example, 2751. Okay, 2751. So okay, fine. And X is your API. It's given in the question. Fine. So, let's suppose I fix one number. That okay? Can I make a triplet use with such that one of the numbers is, let's say two. So let's say I include this number in my triplet. So basically, we need to find three numbers. So that's called a triplet. So now you have taken two as one of the number. So now you need to find the other two numbers, that whether it is possible using two as one number or not. So now you need, so if you have chosen one number as two, so the sum of other two numbers, that should be sum left, let's say that is 8 minus 2, so that is equal to 6. So you need to choose two numbers such that their sum is 6. Okay, so now can you tell me what is the maximum possible sum you can make from these three numbers, the minimum as well as the maximum? Okay, just let me know. 6 and 12. Fine. So just let me take a bigger example for understanding. Let's take it as 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. Let's take the array to be sorted. Okay. So you can always sort the array because the constraints are 5,000. So you are looking for an n scale solution, so n log n, you can do that. So now let's say this is the array, okay, and let's say you fix the first number as 1. Okay, so your sum left, that would be x, I'm just calling it x, I'm working in the variable, so it would be x minus 1. Okay, so now the remaining part, you need to choose two numbers, right? So let's take, so the, how do I explain it? Okay, fine. So let's consider the n numbers. Let's say 8 and 2. We consider the sum of this number and this number. So sum is 10 of, that's 2 plus 8. So if this sum is, let's say sum is equal, so now we have three cases, okay? So sum is equal to sum left. So in this case, we have found our answer, right? We have found a triplet, right? So triplet in that case would be 1, 2 and 8. If x was let's say 10, okay, Otherwise, the other two cases can be sum is less than sum left and sum is greater than sum left. So these are two other cases, right? So let's say sum is less than sum left. So basically, let's say your x was this and this 10. So 10 is less than the required sum. Let's suppose x to be, let's say take x as 18. So x is 18, and so we have chosen one number as 1. So the sum left is your 17. So in this case, sum is your 10. N is less than 17. So basically, whatever sum you are getting using these two numbers, you need to increase that sum. Right. Now you can see, you can observe one thing is that using two, let's say you have to take two numbers from this array, from this subarray, and let's say you fix one number as 2. So what is the maximum sum you can get? Anyone? 10. Yes. So the maximum sum you can get using 2 is 10. So 10 is less than 17. So that means you can say, so that means you can eliminate all the pairs which are formed using 2. Because 2, 3 would give you some 5, 2, 4 would give you some 6, 2 and 5 will give you 7. So all those sum would be less than 17. So you can ignore all the pairs of which are formed using the number 2. So that means you can move one step forward, right? Similarly, consider this, and what is the maximum sum if you find what the maximum sum that can be formed using one number as 3, you will get it as 11, right? So 11 is again less than 17. So that means all the pairs that are formed by 3, they can be ignored because their sum is or will always be less than 70. So you can again move one step forward. So in this case, we can ignore the minimum number. So in this case, the leftmost number, because we have sorted the array, so we can ignore this number. And similarly, if your sum is greater than sum left, let's say your sum was let's say it was seven, so x minus 1 will give you 6. So if it is 6, so if you consider this pair 2 as well as 8, so it is, the sum is 10, so 10 is greater than 6. So that means your 8, so, and that was the minimum sum you can form using 8, because if you take the other number as 2, you will get the minimum sum as 10. So 10 was greater than 6, so that means you cannot form a pair whose sum is 6 and one of the numbers is 8. So that means you can move one step back, you can ignore it. You can ignore all the pairs which can be formed using 8. Similarly, you consider for 7. So minimum sum is 9. 9 is again greater than 6. So you can ignore 7 as well. So basically, what we are doing, we can ignore the maximum number. Right? That is the rightmost number, right? So this is the idea. So have you understood that at each iteration we are ignoring n pairs, because we are ignoring all the pairs that can be formed using 2, and here we are ignoring all the pairs that can be formed using 8. So that's how we are moving forward. We are ignoring, we are checking for eight for n pairs at a time. So we understood this. So now the only thing left is to code it. Okay. So let's code it. Okay, fine. So let's take the number. Take access bin. So basically in the question we are asked to return the positions, right? So instead of making an array, I'll make a vector of pairs. So pii is pair of int comma it, okay? So don't get confused. So just take input as vi dot first, store the element of the array in first, in the first element, and in the second element just make it as I, just make it as the index. Okay, so sort the array first. Vector, sorry. So now fix the first element, right? So I is the first element. So basically pi dot first is the first number of the triplet. Okay, something like this. So now you need to find, you need to check for the remaining part of the array, that can you have two numbers such that their sum is equal to sum left. So just calculate sum left first. So int sum left, that is x minus di dot first. Okay, so now just we just need to check whether we can select two numbers from the remaining array such that their sum is equal to sum left. So let's take two pointers. One will point to the minimum element of that array and other will point to the maximum element of that array. Okay, so we can do something while x is less than r. Okay, now find the sum of the endpoints. So that's vl dot first plus vr dot first. So if sum is your equal to sum left, so this means a pair has been found. So here your triplet becomes, so triplet will be, triplet is, one is vi dot second, the element, the position of the ith element, and vl dot second, vr dot second. So this is the answer. You can store this answer somewhere, maybe in a vector, and you can break out of the loops. Else, if sum is your less than sum left, so that means you need to increase the current sum. So you need to increase the current sum. So that means you can ignore the so leftmost element. So you just 2l plus plus else 2r minus minus. So you can store that answer. Just let me store. Okay. So vector I dot second V L dot second V R dot second. Okay. And after that, you can just break out because you have found your answer. You just need to find one pair. So if answer dot size is not equal to zero, you can break out of this loop as well. So finally, if answer dot size is not equal to zero, you can print the answer. We add one in that because it's zero, it's one base indexing. So else that means there are no triplets present, so just print impossible because that's mentioned in the question. Okay. And just sort that sort the answer vector if they want the indexes to be sorted in increasing order. Okay. Now can anyone tell me what mistake I have made in this part? I've deliberately made a mistake. Can anyone tell me what is the mistake here? L is S, no? Yes, that's correct. So L cannot be equal to R because you should have three distinct positions. So yes, that's correct. So it would be L less than R here. So let's run it. Okay, what's the error? Expected primary expression before this token. Oh. It's odd.
I less than n should be in the for loop. I less than n.
Achha, haan, theek hai. Okay, so just take the same input. Submit it. Yeah, so it's working fine. So does anyone have any doubt in this? Sir, please explain what VL dot first mean. How can we do so? So basically the question was not to find three numbers, right? The question was to find the positions of the array. So because this is the, let's say you have that array. So you had an array 2, 7, 5 and 1. So their positions were 1, 2, 3 and 4. So when you sort this array, you get the array as 1, 2, 5 and 7. So you get this array after sorting. So now you can see that the position of 7 has been changed. Initially it was 2, but now it is 4. So, but we need to, if the pair is found, like let's say the pair was 2, 5 and 1. So the positions, initial positions were 1, 3 and 4. So, but if we, after sorting the array, basically we are applying two pointer after sorting the array. We have sorted the array and then we are iterating over the indexes. So if we use the same index, if we use same I, if we use same L and R, so in that case, it will return you the position of 1, 2, 5. So that would be 1, 2, 3. So this will return you 1, 2, 3. But we needed 1, 3, and 4. So to basically restore these positions, we are creating a pair. We are a pair whose first element is the element itself, and the second part of the pair is the index of that array of that element initially, which is given to us. So that's why we are making a pair. If you have been just asked that whether there a triplet exists or not, or find the three numbers, so in that case pair won't be new. Pair would not have been required here. So does anyone have any other doubt? Right, yes or no? Okay, fine. What about others? Okay, fine. So that was the question. You can try it yourself and submit it. You can solve, let's see. Okay. You can solve this question. Just go through the question. So I'll just explain the question once. Okay, so basically you're given n books numbered from 1 to n. Okay, and will I go to n minus 3 in first loop? Okay, let's see. So it does not matter. Let's say if your I is n minus 1. So in that case, your I will become n and R is n minus 1. So this condition will become false and it will never enter this while loop. So in that case, it won't check any pair. So it's not needed. N minus 3 is not needed. Okay. So there are n books numbered from 1 to n. And the ith book, there's some person who is reading the books. So ith book takes AI minutes. The person takes AI minutes to read the ith book. Okay, something like this. So, and let's say the person has a total of T
Hello, Vikram, I think you are not audible now. Okay, let me check once again. I think he lost his connection. Okay, anyways, let me continue with the same question. So the question link is this one. Let me open it. So I will explain you the question once. So what it is, like, you are given some number of books, n number of books, and for each book the TI time is given, AI time. So AI is the time to read one book. To read the ith book, it takes AI minutes, and the person has got T free minutes in total, that he cannot spend more than T minutes. So T is the number of T is the amount of time he has got, and it is like that, like he will start with an arbitrary book, let us say number book number I, and he will read that book from that place one by one. Like, after reading ith book, he will read I plus oneth book, then I plus tooth, means, and so on. It will continue I plus third, I plus fourth, and so on, and until he will continue the process until he reaches either the end of the array, or means after either all the books are finished, or you can say, like, not all the books are finished, either he reaches the end of the array, like he reaches the nth book, and or it may be the case that his time is over, like he cannot read the next book because already his t time, this time t minutes is over. So any of the cases is there, he cannot continue further. So it is like that. And Valera reads each book up to the end. That is, he does not, he cannot do like that. He may read half book, one fourth book, or so. No, he cannot do that. He will read the whole book, or he will not even start reading that book. So he cannot read books partially. It means that. And you need to find what is the maximum number of books he can read. So he has only T free minutes, and for each book it takes AI minutes to read that book. And he reads in a continuous fashion, like let us say this is our array. Suppose this is 2, 6, 4, 3, 6, something like this. It means that 2 is the time taken to read first book, 6 is the time taken to read second book, and so on. So like let us say he starts reading this book. Okay, so let us say his time is t equal to, let us say, 12. So he will read this book 6 minutes over. Now time remaining is 6. So now time is left 6 minutes. Now he will read this book 4. So 4 minutes more are taken. So the time remaining is 2 minutes. Now this book, if I try to read this book, it will take 3 minutes. So I will not read this book. So what is the number of books I read? Only 2 books. Similarly, he can also start at this place. He can start from anywhere. It is written in the question. He can start from any arbitrary point, but he will continue until either he reaches the end or his time is finished. So this is the question. I hope it is clear. So if it is clear, try to come up with an approach. Whatever approach. It is not necessary to think of two pointers, but whatever approach comes into your mind. And if the question is not clear, please mention. Okay, I will also share the link in the chat or live chat also. You can also get it from the doc. Okay, I will explain it again. So the thing is that for each book, there are n books. Ith book takes AI minutes to read it. And the thing is, he can start from any book, like he can start from any position in the array, like and he will, from that point he will start reading the books until any of these two things is possible, like either his time is finished, he runs out of time, or he finishes reading the nth book, he reaches the end of the array. So basically, if you try to remodel the question, it is something like, since you can start at any point, like I can also start at this point and I can read up to maybe up to this place. But the thing is that some of these values, some of the time taken to read these books should be less than equal to my free time. I have only T minutes with me. So I cannot spend more than T time. I cannot spend more than T minutes. So the sum of the array should be not the full array, sum of this part, whichever books I am reading, that sum of that part should be less than equal to T. If you reframe the question, like you can also reframe the question as basically we need to find a continuous segment of the array such that the sum of elements in this segment is less than equal to T. So we need to find the largest continuous segment, because he needs to read the maximum number of books. You need to find what is the maximum number of books he can read. So the maximum length of the segment which he can read, what is the maximum number of books he can read. So it is like that. You need to find the maximum length of the segment of inside this array. You can also reframe this in this way. So I hope it is clear. Like this 2 indicates that the time taken to read first book is 2 minutes. This 6 indicates that time taken to read second book is 6 minutes, and so on. He can start reading from any place. Like he can start from this 6, and but he needs to read in a consecutive manner. After this book, he needs to definitely go to the next book. Suppose that time is, let us say, he has only 8 minutes free with him. So T is equal to 8, let us suppose. So if he starts at this position, he reads this book. So 6 minutes are over. After reading this book, 6 minutes are over. So he is left with only 2 minutes now. 8 minus 6 is 2. So he is left with 2 minutes only. Now he'll go to the next book, but next book is very large. It takes 8 minutes. So he will not touch that book. It is written in that question, like if he doesn't start reading the book, if he does not have enough time to read it. So he will not read this book. He will not even touch it. So because it will take 8 minutes, but he has only 2 minutes. So he can read only, if he start at this position, then he can read only this book. One book only he can read. So maybe he may start from some other place. Like he may start also from this place. So 4 plus 3 is 7. So yeah, 7 is less than 8. So he can read 2 books in this way. If T equal to 8, you can see 4 plus 3 is 7, and 7 is less than equal to T. This is the question. Okay, someone has shared his approach. Make a prefix array having sum of the time taken to read the books, then take 2 pointers and find the maximum value of difference of 2 pointers in the given time limit in the prefix array. Okay, you can do this thing. Because one thing you must observe is, very important observation here, that all the elements of the array are positive. You can see in the constraints. All the elements are positive because the time is always positive. So AI is always greater than equal to 1. So if you take a prefix sum or something like that, your sum will always increase. So it will be a monotonic function. So if you try to use binary search or something, it should work in that way also. But here, this approach should work. After building up a prefix array, you can do binary search on that to find the subsegment such that the sum is exactly equal to it should be the sum of the segment is less than equal to 2 minutes. You can do a binary search on that. So after making prefix error, so this approach should work, but it will take a time complexity of O of n log n, and also you need to build another prefix error. So it is taking a space complexity of O of n. So definitely if you submit that code on CodeForces, it will get accepted. But now we will come to our approach using 2 pointers. Okay, someone else has also shared her approach. Using sorting, we find to start from the add is less than or equal to T free time. Okay, the thing is, you cannot sort this array. Why? because in the question it is written that after reading the ith book, he needs to go to the I plus 1th book and then to the I plus 2 second book and so on. So the order, if you sort the array, then the order of books will be lost. So you cannot lose that order. The order is very important. So we cannot sort this array. This is a condition, because if you sort, you will get wrong answer. Because in the question it is written that you need to take only consecutive books, like after reading ith book, you need to go to the next book and so on. So sorting will not work here. Okay, so anyone else wants to share his approach? Okay, if not, then we can I will discuss the approach using two pointers. Okay, so let us discuss it. So what I can think is, like, if I have two pointers, let us say L and R. So let us say initially L is okay, let me number the array first. So let us say this is 0, this is index 1, this is index 2. So you almost now have understood that pointer is nothing but in our two pointers, a pointer is nothing but an index in the array, a position in the array. So I have marked the positions of all the elements 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then 7. And then what I do is, like, let us say we have two pointers, one is L and one is R. So initially, L and R, I mean that, let us say if I'm talking about this segment, it means that L is the left border of this segment, R is the right border of this segment. So L equal to 3 and R equal to 5. I mean to say this. So at any time we can consider any segment using these two pointers. So left border of any segment, let us say it is L. Initially L is at 0 and R is also at 0. So we start with the small segment, which is this one. This is small part of the array, which is only a single element 2. So L and R are both initially pointing at 0. So it means we have only one element now. So the thing is, we need to find the largest segment such that the sum of elements is less than equal to T. So what we can do is, we will check the sum of the elements in this segment. What is it? 2. So what we can do is, we will just, if this sum is, okay, let us say that T is given to us something. Let us say T is given as 12. So you want that the sum of all elements in this particular segment should be less than equal to T in any case. It should not be greater than T. So what you will do, you will check the segment, the sum of the elements in this segment, it is 2. So sum is now 2. I will write the sum here. Sum is now 2. So if it is less than equal to 12, what we will do, we will move the right pointer by one place. So I am taking two pointers. So we can take two pointers, L and R. So initially both are at 0. And if sum within the range L to R, both L and R included, is less than equal to T, then we can try to extend the R pointer. Means we can increment R. Increment means increase by 1. So we'll increase R by 1. Move R to the next position. So I can do this thing. I will move this R to the next position. I will keep it in the next position like this. So now R plus plus basically. So now after doing R plus plus, now this sum becomes 2 plus 6, 8. Since I have done R plus plus, now the sum becomes 8. Now I will again check whether this sum is less than equal to T or not. Okay, so yeah, it is less than equal to T. So fine. So it means that this segment L and R, we can read two books. So we can read these two books. So if I want to store it somewhere, how many books I can read? So I can store it as two books. Similarly, now again we will check, since the sum of these elements 8, it is less than equal to T. So sum is less than equal to T, we will again increase the R pointer like this. So R will again point to the next element. Now let us check it again. Now let us increment the sum again, because we have incremented R. So now we are considering this particular segment, these three elements. So what is the sum? just add 4 to it. Earlier the sum was 2 plus 6, 8. Now just add 4 to it. 8 plus 4 becomes 12. Now the sum is 12. It is exactly less than equal to t. So yeah, it is also fine. So we can also read 3 books. So I am storing how many books I can read somewhere here. Like let us say books equal to, earlier I had the answer as, when only we had a single segment of this particular 2, we had the answer as 1. 1 book we can read. Now we increase our segment to this. So we had answer 2 books. Now we increase our segment up to this, L to R. L is 0 and R is 2. It means that we can read 3 books. R minus L plus 1. You can also do that way. So that will give you the number of elements in this particular region. So here are 3 elements or 3 books. So books equal to 3. So we can read 3 books. Now, again, we will, since this sum is less than equal to t, again, we will try to increase it, increase R. So we will again increase R to the next pointer. We will increase R by 1. So R is, I'm moving R only now. Let us see. So now, if you find the sum, what is the sum now? Since the sum was earlier, 2 plus 6 plus 4, it was earlier 12. Just add 3 to it. So just add 3 to it. So now the sum becomes 12 plus 3, 15. Sum, what is this sum? Sum of the time taken to read the books in this particular region between L to R. Since this 15 is greater than my free time, since this 15 is greater than my free time, what can I do? We cannot increase R further. It is of no use. So what we will do, we will now increase L, because we cannot we cannot devote this much time. We cannot devote 15 minutes. We only have this much free time. 12 minutes is given, let us say. So what we will do now, we will increase R, because we have we can say that we have increased R up to a limit where we cannot increase more. So now we will increase L. So let us increase L by 1, means L will point to this element now. Now what will be the new sum? The new sum will be decreased by 2, because earlier this element was in our sum, in our region, but now this is removed. So we will remove 2 from our sum. We will decrease our sum by 2. So our new sum is 15 minus 2, 13. Now what we will do, we will check again. Is this sum less than equal to t? No, it is still not. So what we will do, again, just increase L. So again, increase L. Now after increasing L, what will be the change in the sum? Sum will decrease by this 6. So 13 minus 6 is 7. So the sum becomes 7. So now it is it less than equal to the free time we have got? Is it less than equal to t? Yes, it is less than equal to t. So 7 is less than equal to 3. Oh, sorry, less than equal to 12. 7 less than equal to 12. So it is true. So it means that we can read these 2 books. So we will check. We had our answer as 3. So we need to find maximum number of books. So 3 is already greater than 2. So we'll not update it. Suppose this answer was 4. So we would have updated it as 4. But we need to find the maximum number of books. So I will just keep it as 3 only. So we can read 2 books also. These 2 books also we can read in this way. Now, just do one thing. We will increase this R. Because now since this sum is less than equal to 12, we will increase R. So I hope you have understood the approach. Whenever the sum is less than equal to T, we are increasing R. Otherwise, we are increasing L. So notice one thing. Both pointers are increasing in the same direction. They are both are moving to this direction. L and R are moving both to this direction. And in each step, either L will increase by 1 or R will increase by 1. So can you guess the time complexity of this approach? What should be the time complexity of this approach? And the thing is, the important property you should observe here is why we are able to use 2 pointer is, suppose I am able to read, let us say, this particular segment. I am able to read these 2 books, 4 and 3, these 2 books. So it means that if I take a smaller part of this, definitely I will be able to read it. If I take a smaller part, let us say this one book 4, so I will be able to read it definitely. If I take this smaller part, let us say this one book, so I will be able to read this definitely. I mean to say that if you got a segment which is a possible answer, then all the smaller parts of that segment are also a possible answer. So this is a property where we can use 2 pointers. Like earlier we had our answer as, let us say, this one. These 3 books we were able to read. So it means that if you take any 2 books out of these, then also the sum will be less than equal to t. So you will be able to read those 2 books also. So this is an important property. So if you have any doubt in this approach, please ask in the doubt in the chat, live chat. So what I did, if the sum is less than equal to t, we will increment r. Otherwise, you can say decrease l until sum becomes less than equal to t. Otherwise, if sum is greater than t, we will decrease l, or we will increase l, means we will move l to the right or increase l until the sum becomes less than equal to t. Okay, it is clear. It means anyone else, any doubt? Like only one person has answered. It means some people are not able to think it. So like you can also think this way, like you need to go through all the elements which are you can say which are a possible answer. Possible answer means that some of the elements in that subsegment should be less than equal to t, because what each element is the time taken to read that book, and that sum of the times should be less than equal to t. Sum of the time for reading each book should be less than equal to t. So you need to find a segment whose sum is less than equal to t, and you need to, if there are many segments, there would be obviously many segments, so you need to find the largest one. So okay, let me write the code, then it should be more clear. So okay, so let us write the code for this. So let me share my screen again. So yeah, the input format is something like we have n, then we have t, c in n and t, and then we have the a array, which is having the time for each book, time taken to read each book. So let me take the input. And I'm using hash define int long long to prevent overflow if it is possible. So we have two things, we have n and we have t. Int n and t, let us see in n, then see in t, we have an array of size n. So for each element we need to see in ai, and then we have what we need to do is we need to find the largest segment which has a sum less than equal to t. So the thing is, we can start from any place. So what we did was we started from 0, 0. So now just see the style of writing a code for two pointers. So this style you can follow for almost every question. So like what you do, you place a for loop for r, basically because we are increasing r whenever we have whenever this condition is satisfied, whenever we are finding a possible answer, which is, you can say we are by finding a possible answer, so we are just increasing r at that place. So you can just directly place a for loop for this, for int r equal to 0, r less than n, r plus plus. So for each segment ending at this r, we will be finding what is the largest segment possible. So what we will do is we will take one more variable for the sum of elements in this particular segment, sum equal to 0, let us say, and we will take one more variable for our answer. What is the final answer? Maximum number of books he can read. So what we can do is since you have added after each, let us say r was 2 and after this r plus plus, so it r becomes 3. So after every step you are adding that a of r, so you need to add it to the sum. So you need to increase the sum by a of r. Sum equals to sum plus a of r. So this will give you the sum. And if this sum, like if this sum is less than equal to t, then you can store the length of the segment in the answer. Otherwise, if this is greater than t, while sum greater than t, it means that you need to increase the left pointer so that this sum becomes less than equal to t. So you increase the left pointer L plus plus, and after increasing the L left pointer, you should also update the sum, because you have increased L. It means that now this A of L is no longer in our current segment. So we take one more variable l as initially at 0, int l equal to 0. Haan, so if this sum is greater than t, what we'll do, we will remove this a of l, left element in our segment, we will remove it. So sum will decrease by a of l and l plus plus. We will keep on doing this until the sum becomes less than or equal to t, because this loop will break only when this sum becomes less than or equal to t. So definitely if it comes out of the loop, it means that sum is less than or equal to t. So if it is, if the sum is less than or equal to t, what we can do? Answer equals to max of answer comma. What is the length of this segment? Can anyone say? Which is beginning at L and ending at R. Because we need to find the maximum length of segment. Number of books is the length of the segment basically. What should be the length of this segment which is starting at L and ending at R? Basically, you can imagine left border is L and right border is R. So what is the length of the segment from L to R in terms of L and R? Try to answer. Yeah, R minus L plus 1. Not L minus R, it should be R because R is greater than L. So R minus L plus 1. R minus L plus 1. So it means that this is a possible answer. And why the thing is that we need to find the maximum segment. So we are not decreasing the L further. Notice this thing. Because if we decrease L further, definitely it will be a possible answer. But we need to find the maximum segment, maximum size of the segment. So we are not decreasing L further. Sorry, I mean that we are not increasing L further. And now just we will continue the loop again and again. We will increase R because now the sum is less than or equal to T. So we will increase R, R plus plus. And for this new R, we will calculate the new sum. We will if the sum is greater than t, we will just increment l up until we get the sum less than or equal to t, and so on. We will repeat this process. So can you tell what will be the time complexity of this approach? Try to calculate the time complexity of this approach. I will also paste the code here. So let us sum it also. So try to answer what should be the time complexity in the live chat. Time complexity of this code should be what? So that is accepted. So anyone, you should be able to find the time complexity, right? So the code is also available in the doc. Try to answer, like, what should be the, if it is wrong, it's fine. Like, what should be the time complexity according to you? So someone has told O of n square. Okay. Any other? So the thing is, if it was O of n square, it should not get accepted here, because the constraints, if you see, if you sum it n square solution, it will definitely not get accepted because n is 10 to the power 5. So n square will be 10 to the power 10. So it should give TLE if it was n square. So the thing is that it may look like that there are two loops, one inside another. So it should be O of n square. It may look like this. But remember that in two pointers, the time complexity should be calculated like how the loop is working. You need to think of that. You directly blindfoldedly, you cannot look at the loop and answer that it is the time complexity is like this. So you need to look how it is working. So you see that there are only two pointers, L and R, right? And L is initialized at 0, R is also initialized at 0. This loop will run from R equal to 0 to R less than N. So it means this loop will run N times, fine. Now this inside this, we have another while loop. So this particular while loop, the thing is L++ will occur, how many times it may occur. Since the size of the array is only N, so you cannot increase this L beyond N. So I mean to say that for throughout our code, means for all values of R, in total, I mean to say, this L cannot be increased more than N times. L++, how many times you can do until you are in the array? Like L should be less than equal to N. So this while loop will also run only N times. And N plus N is what? N means 2N. So 2N is just big O of N. So the time complexity is big O of N. So the time complexity is big O of N. The thing is, you need to think how many times can we increase this L and how many times we can increase this R, not more than N times. So this loop will not run more than N times, and this loop will also not run more than N times. Although you may think that it is inside this loop, so for each N, it will run N times, so it should be N into N N square, but it is not like this, because in total, I am talking, like for each R, if you consider this, L cannot be increased more than N times. Is it clear or not? In total, this L cannot be increased more than N times. For R equal to 0, R equal to 1, R equal to 2, for all the values of R, if I sum up how many times this loop will run, so it cannot run more than N times. So just try to think of it once again after the class also, so you should get it. So if you have any doubt, please ask. Otherwise, let us solve the next question, which is just similar to this. So now the thing is, we need to find, okay, I will first share the link. One more thing I want to tell you, like this question is same as in the practice section, you will get a question in the practice section of step 2. You will get this segment with a small sum. So it is same as this question. So you can also try to submit your code over here. So this is the same question. So you need to find the length of longest sum, which is good segment. Length of the longest good segment. So good segment means that sum of the elements should be at most S, not more than S. So this is the same question. So you can also submit your code here. It should get accepted. Let us solve the B part now. Some segment with big sum. So how will you get to this question? You just go to edu section. In the edu section, you go to you first register over for this ITMO pilot course, and then you go to this two pointers method, and there you go to step 2, and there you go to practice. So you will get. Otherwise, I'm also sharing the link in the chat. So the question is, okay, you are given n integers, and let us say the segment of array A from L to R is good if the sum of elements on this segment is at least S. Now here the case is reverse. Like earlier we needed to find a segment which has a sum less than equal to S. But here we need that the sum should have at least S, greater than or equal to S. At least S means what? Okay, that sum should be greater than or equal to S. Now you need to find, if there are many such segments, you need to find the shortest among them. So the thing is, how will you proceed for this? A similar approach can be followed. So okay, let me just erase this stuff. So I told you that we will use in two pointers, we will use this format only. Like we will start L and R both from 0. Most of the times 90% of the cases you will be able to solve the problems with this particular coding style. Like start from L and R both initially pointing at the first element 0, and then if your segment is a good segment or if your segment satisfies the given property, then increase your increase R, or and otherwise if it is not satisfying the property, then increase L until it satisfies the property. And similarly, so what should we do? Like here we need to find the shortest segment which satisfy the property. What is the property here? The property is that the sum of the elements in the segment should be at least S. The sum of the elements should be greater than or equal to S. So let me I have pasted the code this link here also. Okay, so now let us see ki if I calculate the sum here, sum of this segment of one element is sum equals to 2. Fine. Now let us see, let us say S equals to something. We can take 2643689. Okay, I have taken one extra element 4 here. Fine. So we can take let us say we have S equals to 20. Let us say we have S equals to 20. It means that the sum in the segment should be at least 20. So what we will do? What we can do is ki if what we will do is ki if this is satisfying the property, we will increase R. Otherwise, we will increase L until it satisfies the property. So, okay. Can anyone give an approach? How will you deal with it? Like, I have told most of the things. Like, you start from L equal to 0, R equal to 0. Anyone? Okay, let me continue. Like, what should we do is ki if the sum is, let us say here it is 2, so 2 is less than equal to 20, so what do we need? We need to increase R here so that our sum becomes we need that sum should be at least up to this 20. So we will increase our R this time. So 2 will be, now the sum will be 2 plus 6 8, and this R will be pointing to the next element like this. Fine. Again, just do the same thing. 2 plus 6 is 8. So 8 is less than equal to 20. Now, again, like we need a sum at least 20. So we need to increase R. So we increase R. We increase the size of our segment. Okay. Now, what is the sum? The sum becomes 8 plus 4, 12. Fine. Again, 12 is less than equal to 20. We can increase R again. So do the same thing. We'll increase R. Again, let us see. So the sum of this is not still 20 because we need a segment whose sum is greater than equal to 20. So we need to increase R this time until the sum is greater than equal to 20. So again, let us see 12 plus 3, 15. It is again less than equal to 20. Okay, let me write in a shorter way, 15. So again, it is less than equal to 20. Again, increase R. Again, let us see what is the new sum, 15 plus 6, 21. Now it is greater than equal to 20. It is at least 20. Now what we can do is we will, what is the size of the segment? 4 minus 0 plus 1 means 5 elements are there. So this segment has 5 elements from this 2 to 6, 0 to 4. So what we will do, we will store some answer here. So answer becomes now 5, let us say. We can initialize answer to a very large value, let us say infinity or 10. Infinity means like a very large number, 10 to the power 18 or something, or 1 to the 10 to the power 9, something like this. Let us say it was infinity earlier. Now we need to find the shortest segment here. In this question, we need to find the shortest segment, the segment with the minimum length. So we do minimum of the answer, what was the previous answer, minimum of that with our current answer, current length of the segment. So the length of segment is now R minus L plus 1, which is 5. So there are 5 elements you can see. So minimum of infinity and 5 is 5. So the answer becomes 5. Fine. Now we will do the same thing. But now the thing is ki the sum is now greater than equal to 20. So we will try to increment L so that it becomes less than 20. So until it becomes less than 20, so we'll increase L. So if we increase L, L comes here. So now the sum becomes 19. So 19 means we need to increase L again so that our sum increases and it gets at least 20. So we increase now R. So R will increase to this place. And now the sum becomes 19 plus 8, 27. And now this 27 is at least 20. So it is satisfying the property. So we will calculate the length of this segment. Before calculating the length, we can just check. We can increase L until this sum is less than 20. Greater than equal to 20. So if I increase L further, so the sum will be 27 minus 6, 21. So it is still satisfying the property. So I will check whether it can be increased or not. Now it cannot further be increased. So like this, this will be a possible answer. So here, if you check these four elements are also satisfying the property. So we will do answer equals to minimum of the answer, comma, this particular length of segment. So it becomes 4, since 4 is less than 5. Similarly, we'll continue in this way. So let me write the code. It should be more clear when I write the code. So we will be having the similar thing. There are two integers n and s, and the next line contains the n elements of the array. So n and s we have. And okay, since I told you this, that the approach means the coding style will be similar. So just I am erasing this part. And answer is initialized as int max. You can also take int max, means the maximum possible integer. It is similar to infinity. Or you can also take it 1e9. Since the largest length is 10 to the power 5, you can also take it 10 to the power, let us say 6. Or something 10 to the power 5 plus 1. Means in something similar to infinity. Infinity means which a very large value, which is not possible. So that when you take minimum with the answer, you get the answer modified to the newer value. So what we will do is ki for int r equal to 0, r less than n, r plus plus, and inside this loop, since we have added this a of r, we will add this to the sum. Sum becomes sum equals to sum plus a of r. And then what you do? Just since the sum is increased now, so we will just check whether we can remove, means we will, since we want a shorter segment, we want the shortest segment which is having a sum at least s. So we will, what we will do, we will check whether we can remove this a of l or not. I mean to say that sum minus a of l, is it greater than equal to s or not? If this sum minus a of l is greater than equal to s, we can remove it. So we will do sum minus sum equals to sum minus a of l, and we will increase l. So we will keep on doing this until our sum is still greater than equal to s. So this will reduce the length of our segment, and we want the shortest segment. So it will keep on doing this, and at last we will check if this sum is less than is greater than equal to s. What we will do, we will update our answer as answer equals to minimum of answer, comma, what is the length of the segment, r minus l plus 1, and just print the answer at last. The thing is that since all the elements are positive, so whenever you increase, whenever you put or add an element to our segment, the sum will definitely increase, or it cannot decrease. The thing is like this, because this, the elements are not negative here, all are positive. Sum minus, okay, I missed something. While sum minus ai less than equal to s, so it should be okay. L is 0. Okay, it should be greater than or equal to. No space should be there between. Yeah, for this test case, it is working. Let us try to submit the code. If you have any doubt, please try to ask in chat so that I may clear more. Okay, while loop. So in the while loop, what we are doing is we are trying to increase the left border of our segment until this sum of the elements in the segment is greater than equal to s. Because if the sum is not greater than equal to s, it is of no use. We need to only get that particular sum which is greater than equal to s, because we need to store the length of that sum only which is greater than equal to s. So that is why I just checked that if this a of l can be removed from my sum or not. If it is possible to remove this a of l, or you can say the left element currently, which is the left pointer is pointing at that particular element, can I remove it or not? If I can remove it, then what should be the new sum? New sum should be sum equals to sum minus al. So is this new sum greater than equal to s or not? Because ultimately what we want a segment with the sum greater than equal to s. So if it is possible, we will remove it and we'll increase l. If it is not, if suppose after removing this a of l, our sum is still very less, it is still less than s, so we will not remove it, obviously, because we want a sum greater than or equal to s. So if I remove that in that case also, then it will not work. The thing is this: we need to remove only when our sum is very large, very greater than, means like we can remove it from our, we can remove it so that our new sum becomes still greater than or equal to s. Okay, it is giving wrong answer of test 6. So okay, one corner case I have missed actually, I think. The thing is, like, if there is no such segment, then print minus 1. So it may be possible that there is no such segment. So this condition, like this, if sum greater than or equal to s, we are just say storing our answer. But it may be the case that all the elements of the array are very small, and suppose s value is very large. So it may be possible that there is no such segment with the sum at least s. So in that case, our answer would be minus 1. So if, like, I mean to say, if the answer is not changed throughout this process, then it means that there is no such possible answer. If answer equals to 1e5 plus 1 c out minus 1 else c out the answer, this should pass, this should get accepted. Let me try to submit it. It is running. Okay, there are many questions. So can we start from max number in given array, then move right up to s is less than equal to give maybe small segment? The thing is, if you're thinking of sorting the array or something like that, then it will not work here. Like if you sort that array, then positions will be changed completely. So no, it will be of no use, because the positions of all the elements should be the same. The order of the elements should be the same. Whatever is given in the question, we cannot change the order. Still, if you try to find the max element, and what are you saying is you try to find the max element and then move right up to s is less than equal to. This thing should not work, because if let us say if your max element occurs in some array and from there you start your pointer. And like you are thinking greedily, but it may fail in some of the cases. It may be possible that in this case it is passing, but if you think of other cases, it may fail. Because it is just a greedy approach, so you need to prove it some way. Here in the worst case scenario, we will have a space complexity of n. No, why will we have a space complexity of n? We are not using any space, just the given array only we are using. Instead of this, if you leave this given array, apart from this given array A, we are not storing any array. Just we are using these four variables, and four variables are considered to be constant space complexity. So no extra space complexity is required. Okay, But her time complexity will be again O of n. You see, because L can be incremented n times in the worst case, R also can be incremented n times in the worst case. So I mean to say L and R both will be at most incremented n times, so 2n times you can say your code will run these statements. So 2n, or you can say the time complexity is still O of big O of n. Minus one, okay, that thing we have corrected. So I would recommend that you should watch these videos also, like in this course, whatever in the theory, they have provided some videos, so you can watch those also. So those also cover these topics nicely, and if you want, you can watch these step one, step two, only step and step one and step two have the theory videos, so you can watch them and you can try to attempt all these questions. So like, and one more thing is like, the thing is ki when you apply two pointers, only in these two cases, like in binary search, when you applied binary search, only in monotonic functions. Similarly, there is something for you can say for these type of for two pointers, you can apply only in the case when, suppose like you have a segment, let us say from L to R, let us say we have from L to R, we have this segment from L to R. Suppose this is a segment which is satisfying a given property. It can be any property given in the question. So let us say this segment is a good segment. So if I mean to say, if L to R is good segment, good means it satisfies some property given in the question. If L to R is good, is a good segment, then all the segments inside this segment, or what are elements inside this segment, let us say whatever elements are inside this segment, let us say this one, L dash, R dash, if you have some smaller segment inside this. So if this whole segment, the outer segment L to R, is a good segment, or is it satisfies the any given property, then this inner segment also satisfies this the particular given property, then it is called a good segment. So in this case, you can apply two pointers, L dash, R dash. L dash to R dash is also a good segment. Good means it satisfies some given property. I will give you an example. So like what we did in the previous case, we solved a question where we need to find the number of books, maximum number of books that can be read such that your free time is T minutes. So that time we wanted that, like I will write the example in the doc itself. So example is what we solved, sum of elements greater than equal to sum of elements less than equal to some value t. So if suppose that this segment satisfies this property L to R, the segment from L to R satisfies this property that sum of elements is less than equal to t. So it definitely means that all the smaller segments inside this will satisfy this property. All the smaller segments will have a smaller sum, so it will also be less than equal to t. So as solved in previous question, books similar to this, or the it may be in the reverse way also, like it may be like this also, that suppose that if L to R is good, then all the elements outside this L to R, let us say some L dash is outside before this L and some R dash is outside means after this R, so all the elements from L dash to R dash also satisfy this particular property, or also they are also good segments, all the segments outside L to R. So if this is also satisfied, then also you can apply two pointers as we did in the this question, some segment with the biggest big sum. So here what our case was, sum of elements should be greater than a particular value s. So if this thing is true for a segment L to R, then it is definitely true for a segment L dash to R dash. This segment from L dash to R dash is also a good segment definitely. The sum will be obviously greater than R because all the elements are positive in the array. So if this is greater than s, let us say if l2, then the sum of l, all the elements in the segment l to r is greater than or equal to s, then all the elements sum from l dash to r dash will also be greater than or equal to s. So it will also satisfy the property. So if any of these is true, so we can use two pointers in those cases, as you have seen also. So this was to explain you when we can use two pointers. So this is case one, and that one is case two. So in both the cases, we can use two pointers to solve the question. Like similarly, in this question, there you may be asked the number of segments. So what number of segments which satisfy that property? So what you can do instead of minimum this thing, like what you can do is, since in this question, let us say if you were asked that how many segments are satisfying this property, so what we did earlier was just minimum of answer and the length of the segment. So instead of that, you can also do this way. Like, you know that if this is a good segment, then all the segments to the which have a L to the left, like if you have a L dash to R, this is also a good segment because the sum will be also greater than or equal to S. So what you can do for you means you can consider all values of L from 0 to L. So you will consider L plus 1 values. So for a particular R, you will suppose you need to find the sum of all segments which are good segments, which are having a sum greater than or equal to S. So what you will do, answer equals to answer plus L plus 1, this thing, and just see out answer. So if you do this way, so you will get 9 here. Let us see, this is the D part here. In this D part is this one. In the theory, in the practice section, if you go in the step 2, this is the D part of this particular question section. Number of segments is big sum. Because you know that if a segment is good, all the segments which are, you can say, which contain that segment are also a good segment. So we have fixed the R. We have fixed the R value. We have fixed the right border. So if you consider what left what values of left border we can have, so we can have L plus 1 values. So let me try to submit this code over here. You can see this D part is asking the number of good segments, and a good segment is having a sum of all elements at least S. So if you submit it, you will get it should get accepted. If you have any doubt, please ask in the chat. And similarly for the question of the books, suppose it was something different. Like it asked, suppose ki what is the number of segments which have a sum less than or equal to S. So in that also you can do a similar way. In that the number of segments would be all the segments inside your segment R to L to R. So what are the number of segments inside L to R? With the position of R is fixed. R is fixed at that position. You can only change L. So L can be changed from L plus 1 up to R. So that time you will do answer equals to answer plus R minus L plus 1. So to get the number of segments, you can see the C question of this one. So to get that question. Okay, someone has asked why we added L plus 1. So the thing is key. Okay, let me explain it over the whiteboard. So what actually we are using, what we are doing is, let us say we have this particular array and we have fixed the value of R here. R is this one. Now, let us say we have found a good segment from this L to R. R is fixed. Note that the R is fixed. You cannot change this R. Now, at this iteration, in this iteration, you cannot change the R value. Now, and you also found a good segment from L to R. So, since you have found a good segment from L to R, which is the shortest segment, which is ending at R, is it the shortest or not? In the question, you might have noticed that it is either shortest only, and we have found the shortest because we have increased L until we can do it, until we have found the sum greater than or equal to S. So, what I'm trying to say is, ki if this is a good segment from L to R, and you can only change the value of L, you cannot change R, what all other good segments are possible? R is fixed. You cannot change R, but you can change the L value. So L can vary from 0 to 1, 2, up to L. So how many values are there? Including 0. If 0 was not there, then there should be L values. But since 0 is also there, so add one extra one. So L plus 1. This, due to the 0, we are adding one extra one. So L plus 1 values, L plus 1 segments, L plus 1 good segments will be there, which are ending at R. Is it clear? So this was another question similar to this. So try to submit these questions so that it would be definitely beneficial for you to practice. Try to submit it by writing the code by yourself. And if you have any doubt, you can ask. So yeah, it also got accepted. So this was the D part. Try to solve the C part by yourself. I have given a hint. You have fixed the value. We have fixed the R pointer in our way of writing the code. We are fixing the R pointer to some place, and you can only change the L value, you can say. So you need to find the total number of segments in that way. So the link to the question is this one. Okay, so apart from this, we will be sharing some practice questions in this doc itself and also in the Telegram group. So try to solve those, and we will discuss some more problems in the next class. So next class probably we will be solving some implementation problems, and maybe we will discuss some data structure, some of them, stack queue or something. So if you don't have any doubt, we can quit the session. I will just wait for 2 more minutes. If you have any doubt, you can ask. Till that time. In binary search also, if you have any doubt, you can ask. So try to solve these practice questions also, whatever are given in the step 1 and step 2. If your proposal did not get accepted in CyberLab, just try to just pick one division and try to study for what according to whatever the resources are given to you. Maybe they may conduct some test also, written means an online test, so you can prepare that way. online test or assignment maybe. So okay, we can quit the session. Goodbye, everyone.